There's a number of different ways of now exporting this geometry. First of all, the 3D export works the same as the mesh options. Use the icon in the top left corner, choose to export, and choose IFC as the data format. To open the 3D file into Revit so that you can start editing it, you first need to go to File, Open, IFC, and then navigate to the save location. Choose the BIM model. You want to keep auto join elements ticked, but you can untick the other one, as we've already squared off the angles. Press Open and Revit will convert the file into a Revit model. Once that process is completed, which can take a few minutes for large data, we can toggle to the 3D and start to make additional edits. The second way of exporting is to create a 2D slice through the data and generate a floor plan. Use the Create Floor Plan tool, choose a layer, pick OK, and then define a height above the ceiling, either by dragging the face or typing in a value. Press OK to confirm. Again, choose your units and the type of labels that you want to export, and then press OK. The 2D slice is a DXF file, so it can be easily dropped into an AutoCAD template. From here, you have an editable floor plan that you can start to finalize, add additional labels to, and create layouts. For example, you could use the hatch tool to fill in the walls so that they show as solid objects in your plan view. The final option is to create a report as a PDF or CSV file. This is driven from the Create Report option in the toolbar. Again, choose units, choose the objects that you want to export, and then press OK. This can be exported as a PDF or a CSV table. The PDF report is completely customizable and shows you a breakdown per room, and also gives you an indication of how the areas have been calculated.